At first, it sounds like something straight out of a chaotic school experiment, except instead of a few kids in a gym, we're talking about 8 billion people, each weighing around 62 kilograms on average, creating a collective impact of nearly 500 million metric tons. Now, let's get straight to the big question. Can we shift the Earth? The short answer? Not really. But the science behind why is fascinating. First, let's assume we all gather in one place, a massive field somewhere big enough to hold the entire world's population. For reference, you could comfortably fit everyone inside Los Angeles, with standing room only. Then, on the count of three, we all jump. At that moment, we push down on the Earth with the combined force of our weight. Thanks to Newton's third law, for every action there's an equal and opposite reaction, the Earth actually does move ever so slightly in the opposite direction. But here's the problem. It moves by about 1/100th of the width of a single hydrogen atom. That's about 0.00000000001 meters. In other words, absolutely nothing noticeable happens. And even if we all jumped as high as Olympic athletes, let's say half a meter, the moment we land, all that force transfers right back into the Earth, canceling out any effect. The Earth might wobble ever so slightly, but it quickly returns to its original position, like dropping a pebble in an ocean. Now, what if we made this more extreme? Let's assume instead of just jumping, we were somehow launched into space all at once. No landing, no return impact, just 8 billion people leaving Earth's surface forever. Now, things get a little more interesting. If you remove all of us at once, the mass of Earth stays the same, but the balance shifts ever so slightly. Using conservation of momentum, the Earth would actually move about 1/100th of a millimeter in the opposite direction. A little more noticeable, but still nothing compared to the planet's size, which is 6 sextillion tons. That's 21 zeros in case you're counting. So, in terms of planetary movement, we don't stand a chance. But what about other consequences? For one, the noise. Imagine 8 billion people landing at once. That's like 500 simultaneous stadium-sized rock concerts, generating a sound wave that could briefly shake the ground. But don't expect earthquakes. Even the biggest jumps barely register compared to natural seismic activity. A magnitude 2 earthquake releases over a billion times more energy than our little stunt. There is, however, one way our jump could make headlines, if it's synchronized with a destructive event. Let's say we all jumped on a fault line right before a major earthquake. In theory, a well-timed jump could slightly affect the timing of seismic activity, like nudging a stack of Jenga blocks that's already about to fall. But since Earth's tectonic plates move with forces billions of times stronger than us, the effect would still be negligible. So, after all that, what's the final answer? If every human jumped at the same time, Earth wouldn't notice. We wouldn't shift the planet, break anything, or trigger a doomsday scenario. The biggest impact? A lot of confused birds and a weird viral video. But if you're still looking for a way to influence the planet on a grand scale, don't worry. Humans already do that every day. Not by jumping, but by burning fossil fuels, deforesting land, and changing the climate. The truth is, our real impact on Earth comes not from a single dramatic event, but from millions of small actions adding up over time. So, if you want to move the world, you don't need to jump. You just need to take action. If you enjoyed this wild thought experiment, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you don't miss the next deep dive into absurd science. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.